हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू कंपाइलर डिज़ाइन वीडियो सीरीज़। इन आवर प्रीवियस वीडियो हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस अबाउट एरर रिकवरी, व्हाट इज एरर, टाइप्स ऑफ एरर एंड एरर रिकवरी स्ट्रेटजीज। इन टुडेज लेक्चर आई विल डिस्कस अबाउट इंटरमीडिएट कोड जनरेशन। फर्स्ट, व्हाट इज इंटरमीडिएट कोड जनरेशन, व्हाट इज द रोल ऑफ इंटरमीडिएट कोड जनरेशन। इट इज अ ब्रिज बिटवीन फ्रंट एंड एंड बैक एंड ऑफ द कंपाइलर। इन द एनालिसिस सिंथेसिस मॉडल ऑफ अ कंपाइलर, द फ्रंट एंड ट्रांसलेट्स अ सोर्स प्रोग्राम इनटू एन इंटरमीडिएट रिप्रेजेंटेशन from which backend generates the target code. There are certain advantages of generating machine independent intermediate code. First is, compiler for a different machine can be created by attaching a backend for the new machine to an existing front end. And second is, a machine independent code optimizer can be applied to intermediate code in order to optimize the code generation. There are three different intermediate forms. First one is abstract syntax tree, second is postfix notation, and third is three address code. These three are different forms of intermediate form. So first, what is abstract syntax tree? Syntax tree are abstract or compact representation of parse tree. Then what is the difference between syntax tree and parse tree? I will explain you later. They are also called as abstract syntax tree. So a syntax tree depicts the natural hierarchical structure of a source program. Then what is DAG? DAG means directed acyclic graph, which gives the same information but in a more compact way because common sub-expressions are identified. In directed acyclic graph, it considered common sub-expressions. It is not repeated in DAG. So a syntax tree and DAG for the assignment statement, A is equal to B into minus C plus B into minus C is given in following figure. All of you already know how to draw syntax tree from the given regular expression. Just start scanning from left to right, and according to operator precedence, which operator precedence is higher, which is performed first. So unary minus is the highest precedence operator. So first you have to draw unary minus C. Then after unary minus C is multiply with B. So draw unary minus C is multiplied with B. Same is repeated for this B into minus C. So unary minus C, answer of unary minus C is multiplied with B. Then answer of this multiplication and this multiplication is added, then assigned to A. So assigned A. In directed acyclic graph, these both parameters are same, so you have not write it again, just write it once. Here unary minus C multiplied with B. The result of unary minus C multiplication with B is add with same parameters. So here draw just this type of arrows and answer is assigned into A. So this is your abstract syntax tree and this is your directed acyclic graph. Next is postfix notation. All of you know very well how the postfix notation works. In postfix notation, first operand occurs first, then operators are arranged. So postfix notation is a linearization of syntax tree. In postfix notation, first considered operands, then after operators are arranged. So the postfix notation of above syntax tree, which is A is equal to B into unary minus C plus B into unary minus C. Then first convert postfix notation C unary minus. Then after convert B C unary minus into. Then same procedure B C unary minus into. Then these both are added. So after that plus and at the end result is stored in A. So assign in A. Here you can write assign or you can also write equal to sign. Next is three address code. So we already discussed basic of three address code in our introductory second lectures. What is three address code? How the intermediate code generate the three address code? So three address code is a sequence of statements of the general form A is equal to B operator C. This is the general form in three address code. There are maximum three operands. In between three operands, maximum two operators are used. So where A, B or C are the operands, that can be either a name or constant, and OP stands for any operator. For example, here I considered simple example A is equal to B plus C plus D. Then how it can be translated into three address code? Start scanning from left to right. So B plus C plus D. Here three operands and two operators which is assigned into A. So first scan from left to right. There are two operators, both are plus. So priority of left hand side operator is higher than right side. So first B plus C, addition of B and C, then result is stored in temporary variable T1. After that, add D with the result of T1. So T1 plus D stored in other variable T2. But our final answer is stored in variable A. So value of T2 is assigned into A. So here T1 and T2 are the temporary names generated by the compiler. So there are at most three address allowed, two for operands and one for result. So this representation is called three address code. Let's see the same example which we calculate abstract syntax tree and postfix notation. A is equal to B into minus C plus B into minus C. Unary operator precedence is highest. So first convert unary minus C into temporary variable t1. Then after result of this is multiply with b. So b into t1 stored in another temporary variable which is t2. Then after unary minus c stored in other temporary variable t3, b into t3 is stored in another variable t4. So b into unary minus c, result of this is stored in t2, and b into unary minus c, result is stored in t4. So addition of t2 plus t4 stored in another temporary variable t5. Final result is stored in A. So value of t5 is stored in A. So last is A is equal to t5. Next, consider the following grammar. E gives E plus T or T. T gives T star F or F. F gives opening bracket, E closing bracket or ID. And your input string is 3 into 5 plus 4. So just draw parse tree and syntax tree. Syntax tree is a compact way of your parse tree. So first you have to construct your parse tree into this string. So first E gives E plus T. Here I have ID into ID plus ID. So now convert this E into T. E gives T. Then T gives T star F. So T gives T star F. Then F gives ID or digit. F gives ID. Here ID is digit. So represent as digit. ID or digit. So T gives F F gives digit. So T into digit, where digit gives 0 to 9. So digit gives 3, here 5 and 4, because our input string is 3 into 5 plus 4. So 3 into 5 plus 4, how this is represented in syntax tree? First multiplied 3 with 5, because multiplication and addition, the priority of multiplication is higher. What is the difference between parse tree and syntax tree? Parse tree is a graphical representation of replacement process in a derivation, while syntax tree is the compact form of a parse tree. Each anterior node represents a grammar rule. Each leaf node represents a terminal. While in syntax tree, each anterior node represents an operator and each leaf node represents an operand. Parse tree provides every characteristic information from the real syntax, while syntax tree don't provide every characteristic information from the real syntax. Parse tree are comparatively less dense than syntax tree, while syntax tree are comparatively more dense than the parse tree. Now consider the following grammar. E gives E plus T or T. T gives T star F or F. F gives opening bracket, E closing bracket or ID. And generate the following for the string ID plus ID into ID. Draw parse tree, syntax tree, and directed acyclic graph. For parse tree, first E gives E plus T. Then after E gives T, T gives T star F, T gives F, F gives ID, T gives F, F gives ID, here F gives ID. So ID plus ID into ID. This is the parse tree. For syntax tree, first multiplication is executed because the priority of multiplication is higher than addition. So ID into ID, result of ID into ID added by ID. So ID into ID, result of this multiplication is add with ID. And for directed acyclic graph, same input symbol is not repeated. So ID into ID, result of ID into ID add with ID. So this is the DAG, directed acyclic graph. Construct a syntax tree for the following arithmetic expression. How syntax tree is generated from the arithmetic expression? All of you know very well how to solve given arithmetic expression according to its operator, precedence and priority. Parenthesis has more priority. Scanning from left to right. So first convert given arithmetic expression into postfix notation. So a plus b into c minus d plus e or f into a plus b. If you have more than one bracket, then innermost bracket have higher priority. Here we scan from left to right. So first this bracket, so bracket has highest priority. So a plus b, convert a plus b into postfix notation. In postfix notation, first operand, then after operator. So a plus b is converted into a b plus. Remaining expression will be as it is. Now again one more parenthesis, c minus d. So convert c minus d into postfix notation, which is c d minus. Remaining expression will be same. Then after this one. So first E F divide, then after A B plus. E F divide, then after A B plus. Now this parenthesis. So E F divide A B plus star. E F divide A B plus star. Now you have AB plus into CD minus and EF divide AB plus star. So this multiplication has higher priority than this addition. So first AB plus CD minus star. AB plus CD minus star, which is add with EF divide AB plus multiplication. So now this is one operand and this is another operand and in between plus operator. So AB plus CD minus star, then EF divide AB plus star, at the end this plus sin. So we draw a syntax tree for the above postfix expression. So start pushing the symbols of the postfix expression into the stack one by one. When an operand is encountered, push it into stack. When an operator is encountered, then push it into stack and pop the operator and two symbols below it from the stack. Perform the operation on the two operands using the operator you have in hand and push the result back into stack. So continue the similar manner and draw a syntax tree. In this example, first A, B, then after plus. So first draw AB plus, then AB plus, then after C minus D. So AB plus into C minus D, then after EF divide. EF divide, then AB plus. So how this expression is worked for stack? So draw the syntax tree. First draw A plus B, then after C minus D, then result of A plus B and C minus D is multiplied. E divided F, A plus B, result of E divided F and A plus B multiplied. The result of A plus B into C minus D and result of E divided by F into A plus B is added. If you have any variable like answer equal to this expression, then you have to write here equal to sign and answer variable. So this is your syntax tree. So these three are the different form intermediate forms. First is abstract syntax tree. Second one is postfix notation. And third is three address code. Now see the different forms of three address code. There are three different codes for three address code, which is quadruple, triples and indirect triples. So there are three types of representation used for three address code. First one is quadruple, second is triples and third one is indirect triples. Consider the input statement x is equal to unary minus a into b plus unary minus a into b. So first write this expression into three address code. Unary minus has the highest priority, so t1 equal to unary minus a. Result of unary minus a is multiply with b, so t1 into b, which is stored in another temporary variable t2. Next, unary minus a is stored in t3. Result of unary minus a is multiply with b, so t3 into b, result is stored in t4. This result is stored in t2 and this result is stored in t4. So t2 plus t4, result is stored in t5. But our actual result is stored in variable x, so the value of t5 is stored in x. So this is the three address code for given input statement x is equal to unary minus a into b plus unary minus a into b. Now quadruple representation for these three address code. In quadruple representation, with at most four fields like operator, argument 1, argument 2 and result. The operator field is used to represent the internal code for operators. The argument 1 and 2 represent two operands, and the result field is used to store the result of an expression. Statement with unary operators like x is equal to minus y do not use as argument 2. So conditional and unconditional jumps put the target label in the result. So first, unary minus a stored in t1. Unary minus is a operator and a is your argument. So in operator field, this is unary minus argument 1 a. There is nothing in argument 2 and result is stored in t1. Here is the sequence of number which is known as index. Next, t1 into b. So star is operator. First argument is t1, second argument is b and result is stored in t2. So operator star argument 1 t1 argument 2 b and result is stored in t2. Next, t3 equal to unary minus a. So unary minus a, result is t3. Next, t4 is equal to t3 into b. Operator is multiplication, argument 1 is t3, argument 2 is b and result is stored in t4. So star t3 b and t4. Next, t5 is equal to t2 plus t4. Argument 1 t2, operator addition, argument 2 t4 and result is t5. So plus t2, t4 and t5. X is equal to t5. Operator is assignment, argument 1 is t5 and result is in x. So assignment operator, argument 1 t5 and result is x. So this is your quadruple representation for x is equal to minus a into b plus minus a into b. Next is triples. To avoid entering temporary names into the symbol table, we might refer a temporary value by the position of statement that computes. So in triples, there are three fields, which is operator, argument 1 and argument 2. In triples, result is not considered. Instead of results, it uses this number which is identified by index. So unary minus a, result of unary minus a is stored at zero position. So multiplication of this result which is stored at zero position with b. So star 0 and b. Next is unary minus a, this result is stored at second position. So multiplication of unary minus a to b is represented as star 2 b. First result is stored at position 1 and second result is stored at position 3. Add these two result, 1, 3, add. Your addition is stored at position 4. Actually, it is stored in x. So assign argument 1 x. Which value is assigned to x? Stored in fourth index. So here indicated by 4. So this is triple representation. Next is indirect triples. In the indirect triple representation, the listing of triples has been done and listing pointers are used instead of using statement. This implementation is called the indirect triples. So in indirect triples, there is one statement. For example, 0, which is indicated by statement 11. So whenever you used 0, at that time you have to indicate 11 statement. This is indirect pointed, not directly right 0. 0 is pointed by 11, then here used 11 index. So unary minus a stored at 0, 0 is indicated by 11. This is any number. Here I can start it with 11. It is not compulsory to every time start it with 11. Any number you can choose. Next, multiplication of b with the result of unary minus a. Unary minus a result is stored at position 0. But in indirect, it considered this statement, which is indicated by 11. So, multiplication 11 and b. Then unary minus a, position 2. Second position is indicated by 13. So, multiplication 13 with b. Your first result is indicated by 1, which is used by statement 12, and 3, which is used by 14. So 12 plus 14. Your final answer is stored in x. So x assign index 4. 4 index is indicated by 15. So here write 15. So this is the indirect triple representation. In your GTU exam, many times asked this example, like explain 3 address code with the help of following example, or what is the role of intermediate code generation, or explain different intermediate forms. If asked like different intermediate forms, then there are 3 forms. First is abstract syntax tree, second is postfix notation, and third one is 3 address code. If asked like explain different forms of 3 address code, then quadruple, triples and indirect triples. Thank you.